You heard us talk all about FDM materials. Now let's talk about resin. It's time to get back to basics. Thanks so much for joining me again right here on the 3D Musketeers YouTube channel. I apologize for the craziness in the background. We're in the middle of redoing part of the office, but hey, that doesn't mean the videos get to stop. As you can tell, Victoria is off working, so we have her stunt double here with all the same disdain for everybody, as she always has. But we're not here to talk about the cat. We are here to talk about resin, because remember, resin is toxic. And we want to make sure that you know about the resins before you get into it. We're going to stick with a lot of the resins that we are aware of that are out there. You've got Soraya Tech, you've got Elegoo, and you've got Anycubic. Piopoly makes their own resins as well. They're all kind of the same. We're going to go through them a little bit here, just a small bit of detail. And of course, as always, links for all of these products will be in the description down below, some of which are, of course, affiliate links. If you want to see how these resin materials print and some testing of them, get subscribed. Ring that notification bell, because we have some videos coming at you here in the next few weeks all about testing materials and showing off their properties. But let's jump into it. Soraya Tech. Soraya Tech, Soraya Tech, Soraya Tech. They are one of my favorite resin companies because honestly, it just freaking works. Their fast resin is basically our go-to all the time. Their fast gray is amazing in monochromatic LCD resin 3D printers. By the way, if you're wondering what the heck I'm talking about, we did a whole rundown on resin 3D printers card right here. It's an amazing material. It can do cure times as low as 2 seconds inside of mono LCD machines. And in regular LCD, it's like 8 seconds versus 14 for normal materials. It is very, very fast. It has fast post-processing as well. It can be somewhat brittle, but we're gonna teach you how to resolve that in an upcoming video. It involves mixing. But really what Soraya Tech is known for is blue. B-L-U. There is no E. Blue. Blue was normally, well, blue. It's a fluorescent blue coloring, and it was a tough resin, and you can still get it in that light blue color. But now it also comes in blue clear, because reasons. Blue is a phenomenal resin, except for the fact that it needs to be hot. Resin manufacturers have solved this problem by allowing you to add heaters, or you just make sure your room is a little bit warm when you're printing the resin. But it needs to be really above 25°C, preferably above 30°C, because it is such a viscous material. The colder it gets, the more viscous it gets. So you want to make sure that it's nice and warm. We've actually at times used a blowtorch to heat up the resin when it wasn't getting hot enough, fast enough. But we don't recommend that. If you can get blue to print well, which we will be sharing some of our tips and tricks for blue because it is a tough material to print, it is incredibly resilient compared to other resin. You can throw it around, you can use it as an end product, you can drop it, and it's not likely to break. It is considerably more tough than your standard resins. And if you want to do engineering quality on this, we always recommend using a tough resin. Also, it stinks. It is one of the worst smelling resins that we've ever used. And it's really the biggest downside to blue. Most of the other resins that we use have little to no smell. Blue is really bad. So if you are planning on printing blue, make sure it is in its own room or in a room with phenomenal ventilation. Because without the multiple VOC filters that we run in here, the smell from blue is really bad. And if you can smell it and it smells bad, you've got yourself a problem. We want to avoid that. If you are looking for detail, a fast, or even a build or sculpt from Soraya Tech. Build is similar to blue, but it is not as viscous. So you can print it at lower temperatures. It can be tapped. Most resin can be tapped. However, they're not all equal, right? Some resins are more brittle, which makes it a little bit more difficult to tap effectively with a screw. So you can actually make parts that screw together. Build's a great kind of all-around basic material. It is high precision and high resolution, but they all say that, so what does that really mean? Really, when you're looking at high precision, it is all about shrinkage and elongation. I know, he's saying both. Resin has a tendency to shrink a little bit while it's printing, but it also elongates on the Z-axis, and this is due to peel forces. When you are pulling it off of the FEP sheet, there's a force involved in that, and that can cause the layers to elongate ever so slightly. And if you're talking like, and these, you know, these are 50 micron layers. So if you're getting a 1 micron pull every single layer, it doesn't take many layers for that to add up to be an actually viable problem. Something to take into account. Always, always, always do test prints. And understand that the larger your surface area is, the larger your potential for your Z elongation to be an issue. We find that in XY, so that's X and Y, Z is vertical. X and Y resins are all pretty much the same. Some will shrink a little bit more, but you'll get within 5/1000ths of an inch every single time. On Z, it really does depend on the material. But build is a great all around. It is a little more expensive, but it's reliable, and reliability is nice. We get into the fast ABS, like, I don't know why the hell they call it that, but they say it's not brittle. I disagree. I believe that the fast resin from Ceritec is one of their most brittle materials that they have, but you can dope it and add other resins to it, and maybe you'll figure out what I'm talking about by the end of this video, so make sure you watch the whole darn thing. You can dope it to make it a little bit easier to print. We love it because it's very fast, it's accurate, and it's reliable, right? Similar to the build, it's reliable. If I was gonna buy one resin right now, it's gonna be Ceritec's Fast. We used to use their Sculpt. Their Sculpt is a high temperature resistance. It's designed for very, very fine layers. You can go all the way down to like 10 freaking microns on it and get gorgeously smooth 3D prints. It is generally known to be the one that you are going to use as a finished product. Sculpt is amazing, but it is really, really brittle. It's why we no longer use it. It's great if you're doing like vacuum forming, or you can actually use Sculpt to make short run injection molds. So you can like do your own injection molding at home. But just understand it is quite brittle. Beautiful parts, beautiful, beautiful parts, but it is brittle. By the way, don't mix Sculpt and Fast together. Normally that's, we would just, as we go from one resin to another, we just kind of mix them together because they were both gray. Well, the two colors didn't mix perfectly, and on some prints, as we were doing the changeover, you'd see layer striations in color, which oddly looked pretty darn cool, but remember, those two resins have different curing times, so if you are going to keep refilling your vat, make sure you're doing it with the same materials so you don't run into those problems. We have Ceritec Simple next. It's a reliable resin. It's easy to print with. It does require alcohol. So some of these require alcohol. Blue requires alcohol to clean. You need to use alcohol to clean it. Their Simple says it only needs 15% alcohol, but I know that it doesn't need that. If you want to have a video all about how we clean and process resin, let me know. I'd be happy to make it, but only if you guys want to watch it. So let us know in the comments if that's a video that you want to see. But Simple is a great all-around resin. To me, though, I'm going to buy the Fast. I'm going to buy, you know, the Fast ABS Lite before I really go buy the Simple personally. Yes, it is a little more expensive. It's like 20% more expensive to get the Fast, but to me, it's absolutely worth it. Try it out and let me know. Tanks are really cheap, so you guys can easily mess around with different ones, or you just buy more printers like we do. You can get resin 3D printers for like $200. Then we get into one of my favorite resins from Ceritec, and it's, I've never actually printed with it, Tenacious. Not Tenacious D, that's a band, Tenacious. And it is their Flex. It is similar to like a semi-flex FDM material. We actually have Tenacious, but I've never printed in it because we actually dope most of our resins with Tenacious. It is our way to make resins easier to print with. Tenacious is a light amber in color. It basically mixes in perfectly with all the other resins. And what that does is it takes a very brittle resin and makes it way less brittle. But you don't want to dope it too much because then your brittle resin becomes very flexible and you stop being able to print very fine detail. So you have to ride that line between too much and not enough. By the way, Tenacious has basically no smell to it from what I can tell. We move into Elegoo. Similar stuff, but Elegoo has some really interesting resins. They have their plant-based resin, which is made from soybean oil. It's biodegradable. I have not had a chance yet to mess with it. I have some on order, so we're hoping to get it in and be able to play around with it. That's why having a bunch of random old Elegoo Marses is great, because I can play with random resins and it is what it is. But I'm told it's really nice. It's a low odor or light odor. We've got their standard, straight up standard resin. Don't worry about it. Move on to the next one, which is water washable. Remember, resin is toxic. I don't care that it says water washable. Don't wash it in your sink. What it is saying is you can wash it in a bowl of water, cure the resin out of the water, and then you can dump it out. Not down municipal drains. Don't contaminate water supplies. Don't be that guy. But their water washable is pretty darn cool. Instead of using a chemical like Mean Green, isopropyl alcohol, ethanol. I mean, back in the day, people tried Everclear when alcohol got difficult to find. Because it's basically alcohol. That kind of stuff can work, but it's not guaranteed. Water washable resin means basically anything will take it off. And that's useful if you are trying to clean resin. We use Mean Green here, mixturing it with some other stuff. I'll show it to you guys in an upcoming video, but it works for basically all resins except for blue. Blue does not like Mean Green. It needs to be an alcohol. So we use a pickling jar. I'll link to that down in the description as well. And it's something that the industry found like way in the beginning. And it's great for doing really small parts because there's a little pickling basket and you can dunk it into your parts. But anyways, they've got their ABS-like as well. Have not tried it, but I would assume it's similar to Soriatech's Fast. I became a Soriatech fanboy after they had a bad shipment from Amazon and had some of the bottles that leaked. And so Amazon said, no, we ain't getting into this. So Soriatech sold it all at like 50% off. I ordered like 8 kilos of it. And none of our bottles had leaks, so we got 8 kilos of resin for half price. It was great. And the Fast has been so incredibly reliable. And that's what I look for, right? When I'm looking for a resin, I want reliability. Anycubic has similar resins as well. They have a plant-based. They've got their standard colored resin. They have a translucent resin, which is just a non-colored resin. Most companies have it as well. Very standard. They do have a casting resin. Casting is special. Casting resin is very difficult to print. It is not as easy as pour it in, use your same settings, and go. Casting, because it has wax in it, makes it a little bit more difficult. So casting resin specifically is going to be for those that are a little bit more confident, let's say, or willing to spend the time to get it right. We have one printer dedicated to casting resin. We get so few casting jobs that I've actually never been able to get it right. We find that if you get regular resin hot enough, it works just like regular casting resin. So take that for whatever it might be worth. Anycubic also makes a dental resin, and dental is awesome because, as far as I'm aware, it's approved by the FDA. As long as your machine covers those same things, you should be fine. But it is smoother, it's a peachish in color, and it is really kind of for that marketing, right? So you can show someone what a crown might look like, you can show them what dentures might look like. Don't use them as final products, but it's a great test, if you will. Then we have Piopoli. We have their Deft resin, which is very specific to their machines. You can, as far as I'm aware, utilize it on other machines, but they really want you to use it on some of their really big printers. I would guess the Deft resin doesn't have as much of a peel force as some of the other resins. I've never had a chance to play with it. They also have their Neo resin, which is, they claim, easier to remove from the build plate, but also needs less alcohol to clean. Now, I look at that and say easier to remove from the build plates. That means it sticks less to a build plate, which means it may not be good for big prints. I don't know. Again, haven't had a lot of chance to mess around with it. We don't have any Piopoli 3D printers yet. Piopoli, hit me up. I'd love to review some of your machines. That just sounds like a ton of fun to me. But there's a lot of options out there for resin, and we barely scratch the surface, especially when you start talking about companies like Triton 3D. Even Formlabs has their own crazy resins where you can get into things like ceramics and other really, crazy stuff in this industry. If you want to learn about those materials, let us know in the comments below as well. I'm happy to do a deep dive into some of the crazier resins that are available. But we know, since this is all about back to basics, these are all just hitting it really hard. What they do, why they do it, if we like them, if we don't, links in the description as always. My name is Grant. This is 3D Musketeers. Don't forget to call your loved ones. And as always, keep making awesome. Have a good one. Don't be that guy or gal. Don't be that maker. I'm looking at you. Don't be that maker.